Hello YouTubers, welcome to our channel. Here is presenting the next episode of Unexplored History. Peshwas are the Prime Ministers of Maratha Kingdom, Part 1. Number 10. What does Peshwa mean? Peshwe or Peshwa means the principal minister or the prime minister. Originally a Persian word, Peshwa means one who represents or one who always leads from the front. Number 9. Shamaraj Pant Rozekar. In 1642, Shahaji Raja dispatched an initial council of ministers from Bangalore to Pune in order to assist Shivaji Maharaj. These ministers were to help Shivaji Raja to govern the regions in Deccan on behalf of Shahaji Raja himself, since these regions were allocated to Shahaji Raja. The ministry had the following ministers: Balkrishna Pant Hanumante as Muzumdar or the finance minister, Shamaraj Pant Rozekar as the Peshwa or the Prime Minister, Sono Pant Bhadanekar as the Dabir or the Foreign Minister, Dadaji Kondev as Mahala Nihai of the Fort Kondana, that is the parent minister of Kondana and the nearby area, Raghunath Ballad Korde as the Submiss, which is the clerk. Shahaji Raja himself had his own ministry, but it is noteworthy that he did not have a minister assigned as a Peshwa. Hence, it is important to note that this new ministry was established for the cause of Shivaji Maharaj and Shamaraj Pant Rozekar was dispatched as the first Peshwa. Number 8. Narhari Anand Rao. Narhari Anand Rao was appointed as a Peshwa on 21st of August 1661. Not much information is available about this historic character. His name is barely mentioned a couple of times in the available documents, and his official seal is also unavailable. Since his appointment is visible for only about 5 months, it is debated if he was a caretaking prime minister until a full-time appointment was followed. Number 7. Moropanta Pingde. On Thursday, 3rd of April 1662, Moropanta Pingde was appointed as the Peshwa or the prime minister to Shivaji Maharaj. He continued to serve his office until his death in October 1680. In his tenure of 18 years, he not only performed his duties in the office but was also actively involved in multiple battlefronts. He led armies to the Battle of Jawhar, Vikramgarh, Sashti, and the most important Battle of Saler. He also accompanied Shivaji Maharaj during his expedition to conquer the southern India, duly known as the Dakshin Digvijay. He was noted as one of the most trustworthy generals of Shivaji Maharaj. Number 6. Mahadev Pradhan. During the tenure of Moropanta Pingde, there is also reference to a person named Mahadev Pradhan. His official seal is also present on some of the letters dispatched around 1670 while Moropanta Pingde was still appointed as the Peshwa. But whether he was a caretaker or a prime minister is a puzzle to be solved. It could have been possible that he acted in the office to issue the required documents while Moropanta Pingde was away on his war duties. Curious though that his name matches to the name of the first son of the first Peshwa, Samaraj Rozekar. He could well might have been the son of Samaraj Pant Peshwa, Mahadev Samaraj, although this cannot be confirmed. Number 5. Nilo Moreshwar. After the death of Shivaji Maharaj in 1680, Sambhaji Maharaj took the reins of Maratha Kingdom. Barely 6 months into his term, Moropanta Peshwa also passed away. Nilopanta Pingde, son of Moropanta, was then given the duties of Prime Ministry. Nilopanta had earlier served as the Muzumdar and had led armies to the victorious conquests of Purandar and Vajragad in 1670. He continued to hold the seal of Peshwa until 1707. During his term, there is also mention of a person named Gangadhar Moreshwar in 1685, who wrote a few letters from the desk of Peshwa. He could well have been the younger brother of Nilopanta Peshwa doing duties in his brother's absence, although this is an assumption and cannot be confirmed. Number 4. Nilo Moreshwar and the establishment of Pratinidhi's office. After the sudden and untimely death of Sambhaji Maharaj, Rajaram Maharaj ruled from the fort of Jinji in Tamil Nadu for 8 years. Nilopanta continued to be the Peshwa during his tenure, but to have better correspondence with the people in Maharashtra, Rajaram Maharaj appointed Parshuram Kinhaikar as his ambassador. He named it as Pratinidhi and asked him to monitor Swarajya in Maharashtra. With time, because of his physical presence in Maharashtra, the importance of ambassador increased, while the importance of Peshwa or the Prime Minister decreased. Number 3. Nilo Moreshwar and the decline of Peshwa's command. Nilo Moreshwar continued to serve Maharani Tarabai after the untimely demise of Rajaram Maharaj, but references to his letters are scarcely found. It was the emergence of other major players in the politics of Maratha Kingdom which shaped this era. Ramchandrapanta Bavdekar served as the Amatya or the Counselor. Shankaraji Narayan served as the Sachiv or the Secretary. And Parshuram Pant Kinaikar served as the Pratinidhi or the Ambassador. These three pillars virtually controlled over the Peshwa's duties during the significant war with the Mughals. Number 2. Bahiro Moreshwar Pingale. He was the younger son of Moropanta Pingale and was the first Peshwa under Shahu Maharaj. This was after Shahu Maharaj was released from the Mughals. He continued to be the Peshwa until 1713. He was unfortunately captured by Kanoji Angre in 1711. Shahu Maharaj then ordered Balaji Vishwanath to ensure his release and also gave Balaji Vishwanath authority in form of the post of Peshwa. Number 1. The role and duties of Peshwa as per Shivaji Maharaj. We saw the list of Peshwas who fulfilled their duties under the leadership of the first four Chhatrapatis or the sovereign kings of Maratha Kingdom. What duties did they actually perform while they were in office is a great question, and this should be answered now. The duties and responsibilities of Peshwa were defined by the great Shivaji Maharaj at the time of his coronation. There is a detailed list of duties available known as the Kanun Jabita or the list of rules, which was published in 1674 by Shivaji Maharaj himself. The duties mentioned for Peshwas are as follows. The Prime Minister should focus on governing the kingdom. He should bear the official stamp and seal the royal letters. He should be able to lead an army and fight on the battlefield. Once the army conquers a new state, it is his duty to ensure the security of the new state and set the affairs in order. He should be in confidence with the other generals of the army and should be a true leader. All of the above mentioned Peshwas in this list seem to have performed their duties at the best of their abilities. Thank you. Our books based on facts and contemporary evidences from Maratha history are now available online and at leading bookstores in Mumbai and Pune. To share this informative video with your friends and colleagues, please like and share the video. Let us know your views via comments and subscribe to our channel to see more such videos. If you have already subscribed to our channel, please press the bell icon next to the channel name to receive alerts and notifications as soon as our next videos are released. And once again, thank you to all our subscribers as we recently crossed the 2000 mark. Thank you.